Welcome to the opera on Hi-Fi. I'm your host, Isabel Bayraktarian. Hi-Fi celebrates the very best in music and art, and we're pleased to present operas such as Lady Macbeth of Mtsensk. This is a dark and psychologically complex opera, which is often criticized for its sexual content, particularly the way the action is depicted in the music. It has even been called pornophony as a reference to the lurid descriptive music in the sex scenes. At this point, the music, complete with climaxing trombone slides, leaves nothing to the imagination. This opera was a huge hit in its Leningrad premiere in 1934. Shostakovich was only 26. 2 years later, Stalin saw the opera, and he publicly condemned the piece. Lady Macbeth of Mtsensk vanished almost overnight, and from that moment onwards, Shostakovich was faced with a lifelong struggle to maintain his artistic integrity in the face of totalitarian oppression. In Shostakovich's words, Katerina is absolutely understandable. She is the tragic portrayal of the destiny of a talented, smart, and outstanding woman dying in the nightmarish atmosphere of pre-revolutionary Russia, where she is surrounded by monsters. In many ways, murder catastrophically becomes Katerina's only means of revolt in this male-dominated hell. In a work like this, you really can't sing the part of Katerina if you're in any way self-conscious about your body. You will see what I mean when you hear Eva Maria Westberg throw herself wholeheartedly into this role and making it so real in a production by Martin Kusche that's sure to get your attention. And remember, we air operas as they're meant to be seen, always commercial-free. Don't forget to tune in to Lady Macbeth of Mtsensk on Hi-Fi. I'm Isabel Bayraktarian. Thank you for watching Opera on Hi-Fi, Music and Art.